Happy birthday, America, and all of you proud Americans. How you doing, my YouTube viewers and friends? It's Mainly Butch, sliding on through on this 4th of July 2012. I spent the day, like many other people did, with my family in celebration of our nation's birthday. Mute the volume on my Jeopardy game. Yeah, I guess that's what I'm watching. We, like everybody else, had the traditional family gathering of celebration. And in our tradition, we had lobster and steamed clams. I swam in the pool and hung out underneath. We put up a couple of those easy up tents because it was so hot in the sun, and my brother has no trees in the backyard of his fairly new house. I'm 6 or 7 years old, and this has huge lawns, but no trees. We explained to him they needed to plant some trees. I think they avoided the trees because they don't want to rake. But you bake in the summertime. Bake. It's a vast, expansive backyard, a few acres, so really need some trees, dude. Having a cup of coffee because I came home and about an hour ago I copped a migraine. Sometimes that happens to me with lobster and clams. I don't know what it is. As I've gotten older, I've developed some sort of maybe an allergy to them. I'm not sure. I love them. And everything seemed to be going okay today, so I actually had a second lobster, which was a mistake because I've been sick tonight because of that. Okay, you know, me wrong. I'm not all sick, but I got pretty sick, and I got a major, headache. It's pretty much gone now. I took migraine medication after I got sick. And coffee is the key for me with migraines. It will help me to make a migraine go away, or at least to abate the pain a bit. So, anyway, yeah, it's an interesting day. You know, the whole family gathering and the swimming pool thing, it's always a little uncomfortable for me as a butch. I'm out there, all the girls are out there in their bathing suits and stuff, you know, and I'm in my little swim shorts and cut-off t-shirt like this. Sometimes I'll wear just a sports bra, but I decided just to go with the cut-off t-shirt today. I just didn't feel right, you know, but I don't shave my legs, and I know I always get the looks from my sisters about it, and, I don't know, the swimming thing is sort of in line with the bathroom issue sometimes. For me, anyway, you know, it's can be uncomfortable when there's a lot of people around. Because, of course, you know, it's not conforming to my assigned gender that I don't shave my legs. Because if you're a woman, you're supposed to shave your legs, right? No. not this butch. Yeah, it kind of, like, flies directly in the face of the fact that I wax my eyebrows, right? Yeah, I've been reading a lot about gender nonconformity lately and about this sort of perceived sort of disappearance of the butch identity in the LGBT community that a lot of people are experiencing. And why is that? And I was reading one blog tonight, which I thought really hit a lot of it on the head, because they were saying in there that, you know, if any one single phenomenon causes queer people who no longer identify as butch, if you had any one singular phenomenon that would actually maybe, really cause us to not want to identify as butch publicly, it would be actually the unbelievable existence of transphobia. Believe it or not, transphobia affects butch people very much because, you know, we don't conform to the normal, the current social expectations and, you know, the perceived expectations of what we should look like in appearance as women to most people. So, you know, they are not sure, you know, if we're trans or what, and they actually become transphobic against butches. And I think that person had it right. I think that is a phenomenon that definitely I think affects some people in their choosing to identify or not identify as butch. You know, I think that a lot of people think that if you identify as butch, it's just like a step along the trail to being trans. You know, I don't believe that. You know, myself at all, you know? You know, I absolutely am very masculine. I identify as very masculine, all right? But I don't identify as trans. And I don't, you know, I've really thought about this a lot. And I'm trying to think, you know, if I was 20 years younger, would I do it? Would I, you know, transition? And I kept to say no, because the thought of changing my actual, what do you want to call it, your birth gender or whatever, okay, change, you know, it's okay that I was born a woman, you know, I feel more comfortable acting, or just being. I don't even act, it just comes to me, this is, you know, the way I am, and, you know, the fact that I was born with female body, that's the way it was supposed to be for me, I guess, you know, but it definitely, you know, transphobia and homophobia, you know, are definitely something that I didn't think about this before, and I was trying to put my finger on what it was, you know, and I think that blog really explained it in saying that transphobia affects butches, because it does, you know, and I hate, yeah, I was reading a lot about transphobia, and, you know, things like it, you know, the stereotyping and everything, and I may have to do more vlogs about it, I may have to study more, and I may have to, like, put out some more of my thoughts about it, but I just thought that was kind of like an eye-opener for me tonight to think, yeah, you know, it is, because although I'm butch, I don't want people to think I'm trans, but then where does that leave me? That leaves me being transphobic, right? And I don't want to be transphobic. I'm not transphobic. Or I didn't think I was, you know? And I mean, I'm being really honest here. I'm not, you know, I'm not trying to piss anybody off. Please, don't be offended, okay? I have trans friends, and I love and respect them, you know? And I know that is, you know, transphobia for you guys is, you know, 10 times, you know, worse. I'm just saying there's a little piece of it that is maybe pushing the butches away from identifying as butch. And now I can actually understand why this vlogger that wrote this blog, I get vloggers and bloggers all fucked up, you know, put it into, you know, sort of a picture that I could understand it better at. So anyway, that's kind of my topic for tonight. What do you think? You know, it's really funny, because before I comfortably identified openly as butch, I sort of felt that way. I didn't want people to think I was butch, you know, for a few years there, I remember back, you know, and it was because there was some sort of a bad connotation to being butch, that, you know, it somehow meant you really did want to be a guy, and that's not true, you know, I don't know how to say it in at this moment in the right words. Maybe I'll find them and do a better blog about it, but, you know, I do remember feeling that way a long time ago. Now I proudly identify as butch and openly, and I don't, you know, care if people like it or they don't like it. This is me. You take me or you leave me the way I am, you know, but I definitely can understand, you know, what this blogger was saying, and they also said that it actually has a generational sort of effect going on with it too, that in the 40 and over crowd, it's more prevalent. People don't want to be recognized as butch because of the fear of transphobia than younger people, and I get that too, because, you know, obviously younger people are exposed to more at an earlier age, and they're not exposed to what we were exposed to in the over 40 crowd, you know, as far as homophobia went back in the 60s, 70s, and 80s, when it was real bad, the Stonewall years, and all the shit that went on, so I sort of get that. Anyway, I hope you had a great fucking 4th of July. I know I did, I love my family, and I actually had a really good day. I sort of let go and relaxed and said, "Hey, let's just do it." And we had a lot of fun, and I really enjoyed being around all the kids, and the kids enjoyed having me around, which was really cool. Nola unfortunately stayed home today, and tonight it's kind of rumbling outside, so she's on the couch in her thunder blanket, and she keeps making sure that I'm here. If I get up and move anywhere, she's right on me, because if it starts to thunder, God knows she needs to be a burrito instantly. Peace. Happy 4th of July. Be safe.